Mike back here again with the Golden Gate Chapter, and we have a special guest here because he's not from the Golden Gate Chapter. He's from
the LA Chapter.
And your name?
Mike. Awesome.
Also Mike. Yeah. Really easy to remember. So you're new to the chapter, the LA Chapter. So how long have you been a member of the CCA?
I've been a CCA member for about 5 to 6 years now, I think. I joined when I got my first 635, which is around kind of 2012, 2013. So, okay. Yeah.
What inspired you to join the club?
So I'd always been infatuated with BMWs ever since, you know, I had a neighbor who had an E36, and my first fascination was with E36s. I bought a total dog of an E36 as my first BMW, and then realized that that wasn't the car for me. The E24 was the car for me.
Awesome.
And I stumbled across E24s. I worked in a Euro repair shop when I was in high school, and knew a guy that had a US 86 635 CSI.
Right, this is what we see right behind us
so
here.
So this is a one? Euro 635
CSI. Oh, wow. CSI. Okay. I think it's only the second one I've seen that's Euro.
Yeah, it's so it's got the Euro bumpers, and these cars came with kind of fun sort of Euro pinstriping on kind of the bullet valance.
Okay, right there.
You'll see that's
in the black.
A little bit different. Yeah.
Does the bumper stick out a little bit more, I think? Is that right?
So the US bumpers, you'll see a perfect comparison.
Okay,
right
there.
That's basically the same bumper that came on the US 635.
Okay.
Where it comes out a little bit more, and these just are tucked in a little bit. You'll see that this around is painted.
I guess maybe because us American drivers like to play bumper cars a little bit too much, so they have a bigger bumper.
Well, they call them 5 mile an hour bumpers for a reason. So. this car is basically bone stock. A 82, and it's one of the last E12 based cars. It's based on the first 5 series. It has 16-inch best weave style pads.
Yeah, look at those. Yeah.
They're good. They're great for 16s in general. I think are the best.
The best look
to have on a 635, just because of the ride comfort.
Attention.
And the handling is really good too.
1 o'clock is going
and,
to be.
And let's see what else. This car has a dog-leg gearbox that you could only get on the early cars, which I don't know if you can really see. But on the other side, yeah.
Is over on the stage.
It's a close ratio dog-leg, very similar to what you got in the 30M3
next to the clubhouse.
Awesome.
Again, that's 1 o'clock.
Other than that, it's a kind of a regular run-of-the-mill Euro 6.
So you got spoiler, is it rubber spoiler? Interesting.
It's funny, yeah. These are for some reason, these are rubber. They physically bend.
Wow.
That's
crazy.
This is actually the second Euro car I've had. And they're both, I had the same thing with my other spoiler, and I first got it. I was like,
what is this, right?
It's so weird, but it's literally viable.
And there's the BMW part number
right
there.
You got the part number, yeah. I think it's matching. I gotta replace this thing. Nasty over here, but this is kind of I just picked this car up. It's sort of a project car. I'm gonna start working on it. It's obviously needs a little bit of kind of paint touch up and things here and there, but mechanically it's really solid. I just drove it up all the way from LA.
Just for this event.
Just for this event, yeah. Pretty much. And it's a fun car. It handles great. You understand why these things are such great highway cruisers when you really go ride them, when you take a trip.
And what an excuse to take a trip, right?
It's been a good car, yeah. And this is the 3024 I've had now, so I'm pretty familiar with them now. You never know when a good one's gonna pop up.
You're always checking online.
Always, every single day. You gotta find, anything that comes up, you wanna snatch it. especially these cars, because they're kind of continuing this sort of slowly go up and up. As years go by. So. Yeah.
This is an awesome looking car. I'm glad you're able to bring it up here and share it with everyone here. And now, everyone here on video as well.
Yeah, awesome.
So I guess one quick thing before we go. What do you think is the best thing about the car club?
First of all, these events are probably, the reason why I do this whole thing. I would say probably, events like this, being able to know, having an in with the car club, being able to kind of buy your ticket and everything through the car club, and just No, also just the people, you know. Right. I've met so many, like, amazing, really cool people that have, like, told me things about my car that I didn't know, told me things about BMWs that I didn't know, just genuinely got me, like, more interested in, like, being a part of the community, you know, making it very difficult for me to leave if I ever wanted to.
Right, so once you're in, you're in.
Yeah, once you're in, you're in. Yeah.
Right, so I think it's a theme among everyone I've talked to. It's always about the people. Cars sort of bring you together,
yeah.
And the people make you stay.
Yeah, I mean, for me, it's like, I don't come here to really just, like, park my car here. It's to, like, to meet people. And especially for someone like me, who's just moved 3,000 miles. I'm originally from the Connecticut Valley chapter.
Right, I feel you. I came from the National Capital Chapter last year.
Right.
And I got involved. It was an easy jump in. The people.
Exactly.
I was a little nervous at first. I was like, what if they like me?
Yeah.
But it's not. It's like, basically, everyone's the same. Everyone's really friendly. And we'll help you out and everything. Get you involved.
Yeah. So, you know, I already have this little community here of, like, CCA people that, you know, I'm just starting to meet. So it's a great community. And especially in California, it's, like, one of the coolest places to be for BMW. So.
Okay. Oh,
yeah.
All right. Well, Mike, cool. Thanks for your time. Thanks for sharing the
call. Yeah, thank you so much. All right. Appreciate it.
All right. See you guys.